So this is a sample of rubidium. It arrived a couple of days ago from Alpha, the company. So there's 1 gram of rubidium. It cost about £65. It's one of the alkali metals, so it's very, very reactive. A bit like sodium, but perhaps a little bit more. So the metal itself is quite low melting. It won't melt with my hand though, unfortunately, so I'm not going to show you it liquid now. But you can see there's 1 gram of the metal inside this glass ampule. It's very reactive, and we're going to explore its chemistry now by putting this into some water. Well, we've got this really neat device which Neil put together last Friday, and you can see it's got a hammer which is going to break the glass.
Show us, Neil. What does it do, mate?
So when the hammer falls, literally, we'll break the glass, the rubidium will just drop into the big bucket of water that we've got underneath.
Rubidium is an alkali metal that comes between potassium and cesium. And both potassium and cesium are much better known among chemists than rubidium. Potassium, because it's all over the world, the environment, you have potassium in cells and plants and so on, I mean biological cells. Rubidium, on the other hand, is quite rare.
So I'm going to give the sample now to Neil, and Neil's going to load it, and then we're going to drop the hammer on it. There you go, Neil.
It was discovered originally by the German chemist Bunsen, or Bunsen as he was called, the one who invented the Bunsen burner, and he discovered it by looking at the colours that you see in flames when he was heating up water that came from mineral water that came from springs somewhere in Germany, I believe, or it may have been somewhere in Middle Europe.
So Neil is arranging the sample of rubidium against the metallic back plate in the small metallic collider.
Rubidium gives a characteristic colour that is different from lilac of sodium, or lilac of potassium, or the orange of sodium.
The rubidium is slightly more reactive than sodium. So when we did the sodium experiments, we had our safety glasses and coat on. But for rubidium, we're going to wear secondary goggles. So here's my safety goggles, which I'm going to put on top. Don't we look good?
Nowadays, one of the main uses of rubidium is actually in physics rather than in chemistry, because you can heat up rubidium metal to a high temperature and get a vapor of rubidium atoms in a specially constructed heated cell. And you can get very interesting effects from shining very intense laser light into rubidium atoms. And the rubidium atoms can do a whole series of different, very elegant physics experiments. So rubidium has got a life of its own in physics, but in chemistry, it's perhaps slightly neglected.
See that tube still? Was that it?
Don't think I needed my safety screen.
Well, that wasn't very exciting, was it?
There could be some in there.
Yeah. There was a gas tube at the bottom thing. This was pumping in the gas tube.
It's all gone.
You were right, it was just a fizzle.